2 years ago, my brothers and I came up with the idea to make a show about cars that we would enjoy making as much as people could enjoy watching. We love cars, and we've owned literally hundreds of them. And spurred on by all the incredible things that you guys had to say about us in our first couple of shows, we are Talk Show.
A lot of incredible things came out of the 80s. Kylie Minogue for one. But exactly 30 years ago this year, a legend was born. That legend soon became one of the world's best loved hot hatches. The fact that 30 years on, it's still as much loved today as it was back then is testament in itself to just how good this car was and still is. It is the Peugeot 205 GTI.
Start again, another take, here we go. Welcome to episode 3 of the Talk Show. Today we've got something truly spectacular for you old school petrol heads and likewise something for you modern day car lovers too. We have got the iconic Peugeot 205 GTI versus the 208 GTI.
We're gonna put them head to head and see which one is the very best. Could it be the nostalgic feeling of thoroughbred hot hatch or the technological gadgetry of the new 208?
So here's what we're gonna do. Here we go again. This car takes us back to when we were budding handbrakers, Matt. Do you remember in Tesco's car park? So in honour of these memories, we're going to bring them back and we're going to feature them in today's episode as part of the challenges to find out how well these two cars do actually perform against one another. Okay, so here we are, the moment I've been waiting for. I'm in the 1.6 205 GTI, Matt's in the 1.6 208 GTI.
Traction control off.
Yep.
Just about to kick off with a drag race. He's got 200 brake horsepower, 130.
See you later, Jared. Bye.
Dog walkers everywhere, no, every single place I'm going to, there's dog walkers.
I didn't get your credentials, who are you?
I'm a local resident.
Sorry, we came here to try and put some cheeky handbrakes.
Okay. No vehicles allowed up here at all.
And basically now we've been here to bring it up.
And we've been informed that if we see any motor vehicles on the disused airfield, we're still reporting to the local police.
Bye.
So let's check out how well this car handbrakes.
I interrupt your regular broadcast to bring you this important news bulletin.
Jerry, you are an utter b***. This bad boy out, okay? Here we have the 1.6, 113 horsepower in all of its glory. It looks spectacular, it really does. And I tell you what, 8.7, 0 to 60.
Really?
Yeah. Anyway, a beautiful car, a beautiful engine.
Whoa, stand there.
Yep. Yep, nice.
Okay, you ready?
Yep. Nice. I tell you what's interesting as well is between the two eras of cars is how design has changed, hasn't it, Matt?
Yeah.
Back in the day, man, this was it.
How big are your wheels?
Yeah, they're 14s.
Yeah, those bad boys are 17s. What about LEDs in your headlights?
No. My wing mirrors are manual.
Okay, you
manual.
Have tinted windows, but they're not as tinted. You've got a little bit of flimsy plastic.
I've got a little bit of flimsy plastic. Let's now
just go for a general drive in these cars. Yeah, let's see what we think.
Yeah.
And
okay, so we're waiting for Matthew to come back from the urinal.
Did you just go in the car park?
I think he went over there in the corner, which
that
is pretty disgusting.
Yes,
it starts every time.
Jared, I cannot believe
button.
I am actually winding a window up.
What you need to remember is, this car didn't have a Mercedes price tag, Matthew. But I tell you what, it's a damn sight more fun. It's rickety, it's old.
Yeah.
Draft comes through from the windows.
Speedo's wobbly.
You worry. Okay, so the steering's quite heavy, as you would imagine. There's no power steering, but it does only have these little baby 14-inch pepper pot alloys. So what you guys are going to love about this car is the sound. How wicked is that?
What are the brakes like?
Look, you've got drums at the back, discs at the front.
Yeah?
Yeah, on the 1.9, I think you probably
discs
would have come
round.
With discs all round. Yeah, yeah,
they push did. Buttons. Like, yeah.
All right, stop pressing, man.
Don't.
Yeah. Let's just quickly talk about the value of these things. A good one of these, just like this car, goes for around £13,000 to £14,000, which is a premium price. But this car here has only got 29,000 miles from new. You can actually pick up a project car for anywhere from £2,000 to £3,000.
But you're not going to find one as nice as this.
No.
At the same time, when we had our Renault 5 Turbo, they were a lot more fun.
Well, that
to
was
drive.
The next evolutionary step, wasn't it? Look, if we were going to put them in an order of what was the best, some would argue the Golf GTI was the best for its build quality. I think the Renault 5 Turbo would be the best in terms of like its power. But I think this, as a general all-rounder, would probably pip the post, don't you?
Yeah.
It takes me back, Matt, to my early days of being a pizza delivery boy. There was this mad, crazy, jealous kid who used to drive around in a 1 litre Fiat rubbish Uno in pea bile green.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he used to chase me around. We very aptly named him Uno Boy. Let's just run through its technology. George?
It's got a CD player, right?
No.
No, you have this piece of plastic.
What does it do?
Okay, well, it plays music. Right. And it goes in this big slot down here.
So it doesn't have a CD player.
No.
Which is bizarre. Air conditioning?
No.
No.
Bluetooth?
No.
Bluetooth.
No.
USB?
No.
No.
Does it have ABS?
No. No, none of that. No, actually.
What has it got?
As far as like modern day road safety is concerned, very little. Absolutely no doubt the 205 GTI drove considerably better than the 208 GTI.
Did you actually drive the 208 GTI yet?
No.
So, we've got 200 brake horsepower.
Yep.
1.6.
Yep, and it sounds good, I would agree.
Well, it's quiet, it doesn't actually make a noise.
What does it do 0 to 60 in, Matt?
6.5 seconds.
Is that probably, or do you actually know? How much research did you do on this?
Would you agree that this is a very pretty looking car?
It's a very pretty car.
George, do you feel safer already?
I have a 3-point harness.
This is lovely.
Isn't it nice?
Really, really nice inside. Some swanky London bar.
It is. Look. Double-stitched red GTI lines going through here. You've got red bits in the gear knob.
Yeah.
It's got like a carbon fibre effect sort of dials. It's got a small squared-off steering wheel.
I know. You kicked my ass in the drag race.
Yep, and a handbrake challenge.
But is it a true GTI, Matt?
You don't feel every bump like you do in the 205. To be fair, it's not even fair to compare it. It's separate, you know? Okay, look, one of the biggest issues I've got for this car.
Tissue for you?
I do need a tissue for my issue. Can I have one, please? The dial set up here sits too high. The top of the steering wheel is in my line of sight. Yes, I can move the steering wheel up, which makes it even worse, or I can bring it right down to here.
So what you're saying is that speedo's in the wrong place.
The whole cluster is in the wrong place.
Burn him off the lights. I want to feel this 200 horsepower. Go. I bet you don't wheel spin because you've got like traction control and anti-skid regulation and stuff like
that.
Anti-skid regulation.
Yeah.
No, Jared has that.
Yeah, Matt, you need it for your patents.
Oh, I love it.
We'll have to redo all that footage because Matt's got some in his teeth.
Oh, this has got sat nav as well.
It's got sat nav. It's got.
I think to be honest with you, this little this car doesn't have. I just wonder whether that is
a bit different to yours, Sharon.
But is there anything in this car that really does say I'm still a GTI?
When you drive it fast, it's very responsive in the corners. It turns in perfectly. The seats are comfortable. They hold you nicely.
Yeah.
You've got dual climate control.
It does meet every modern day criteria as class and style is concerned, doesn't it?
Yeah, absolutely.
It really does.
You can hit a pedestrian without killing them. It's got a nice weighted gear shift. Okay, it's not flimsy and feels like it's going to fall apart like your one. You get two USB ports.
Stop babbling on about technology. You don't need it in the car.
But that's why you have a little classic.
Well, I'm really impressed, I have to say, with both cars. So I don't know how we're going to call this one, Matt.
Pub.
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 Pub. Pub. Pub.
Back on track. Okay, so we drove the 205 GTI versus the 208 GTI.
Which was great fun.
So much fun. Yeah, why? Which car do you like better and why?
I loved the 205 to the point where I would go and buy another one to drive
an hour on a sunny summer's day down a country lane, and then I'll park it back in the garage and
leave
it.
The absolute tips
I would. 208 I really did like, because it's so easy, reliable. So far as a modern day hot hatch goes, mm-hmm. it's got it all. It's got 7-inch touchscreen, it's got the multimedia functions, yeah. sat nav, it's got the cool seats. You know you're in something a little bit special. Okay. It's not as fun to drive, but then again, you've got a safety.
It's been compromised by all modern day.
Yeah, basically, yeah.
It's a car for today. Mm-hmm. The 205 is not a car for today, yeah. but yeah, 30 exactly years right. ago, that was the modern car.
I think the 205 did put more of a smile on all of our faces.
Okay, honestly, right. So to summarise, we are all in complete agreement that we both like both cars. They've both got different elements.
Yeah.
We love the nostalgic feeling of the original
thoroughbred hot hatch.
The technological gadget.
So
give
to sum
off a lager shirt, he's all over the shop.
So thank you very much for tuning in and watching this latest episode. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as we have. Tune into our next one. We've got the Honda, what is it, CR-V coming up. It's going to be good. It's going to be exciting. We've got some fun stuff for you to watch. So subscribe on YouTube, follow us on Facebook and tweet us on Twitter. And also check out our website on www.talkshow.tv. Guys, we're out of here.
Two years ago, my brothers and I came up with the idea to make a show about cars that we would enjoy making as much as people could enjoy watching. We love cars, and we've owned literally hundreds of them. And spurred on by all the incredible things that you guys had to say about us in our first couple of shows, we are Talk Show.
The Swedes are renowned for many things. ABBA, affordable flat pack furniture, and of course, Volvo. Born and bred in the harshest of winter conditions, this car was designed to be strong and safe. So if you did happen to slide into a reindeer, neither you or them would be injured as a result of its unrivaled safety features and 5-star ratings. In fact, little do people know that even its logo demonstrates solidarity and strength, the chemical symbol for iron.
Morning, here we are on location, waiting for Gerard because, as per usual, he's late. Chris is here, George is here, I'm here. Where is Gerard?
Take one. Episode 4, here we go.
Of the Talkshowness. Hello and welcome to episode 4 of the Talk Show. Super excited to be here today. We're featuring the Volvo V40 R-Design D4.
That's right. Now, the Volvo V40 first launched itself in 1995, but they've relaunched it with vigour as a hatchback, and this being the R-Design version is super cool and looks wicked.
Exactly. What Volvo did with the R-Design is to compete with the likes of the Audi S-Line and the BMW M Sport. So it's aimed definitely at a much younger market than traditional Volvos.
But you know what? I mean, as a result of it looking super cool, and it really yeah. does, we yeah. need to check out and see if this car drives as good as it looks.
Yeah, absolutely. And we're going to get George to drive it later as well.
Why?
Because he needs to have a go in it.
He can't drive.
He can.
I know, he doesn't drive very well.
He does.
We'll find out later.
Ish.
He's a lovely. I don't know where I'm going though.
Okay, George, we're just going to go straight forwards. Follow the way towards. Well, George, we need to go towards Guildford.
Yeah, which is where? That says Ripley. I don't know where Guildford is.
Go towards Ripley then, I guess.
Where is Ripley in comparison to everything?
By the way, yeah, it comes with a load of sicko cool safety features as well. We're going to find out just to see if they actually do work and how well they work.
George, quickly, come here before Gerard does.
Right,
okay, right. You know, he's got the active brake thing. We're going to draw straws on who takes it. Listen, we want Gerard to do it. You need to take the left straw. I'm going to go with the middle one. Right. Gerard takes the outside. Gerry, come over. Okay, right, simply, the car's got the active brake safety system, okay? Yeah. Someone's got to stand in front of it.
To test it, make sure it stops without crashing
in front of a car.
Well, no one said you're doing it. We're going to draw straws. Someone's taking one from the team. That's reality of it. I'm going to go first. I'm going to go for the middle one. Georgie?
Okay, where's this closest? That's most definitely
short. Oh, I've definitely got a longer one there. Don't panic. I've actually got something to protect you in case the car hits you.
I'm not comfortable with this.
The car's got a 3-star pedestrian safety rating. So worst case scenario, you're going to get kneecapped.
3-star?
3-star, that's the max a car can have for hitting pedestrians. But don't worry, wait 1 second. I'm going to show you something. Right, for whoever was going to do it, I've actually had this donated by my mate from the Basingstoke Bisons. So you're going to be wearing that. I'm going to help you pad it up. Sick. Look, you've got all the kit. I'm going to help you put it on. And then we're going to drive the car at you.
Better not be lying about this working, mate.
See, it's a paddy, put your feet in there.
Oh my f***ing God. Am I in? I got one glove. One glove. And a ba-da-ba.
Good luck, Broski.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
Shit. Oh, ow.
I'm not going to tell you now, but I didn't activate the system.
Thanks, buddy. Thanks a lot for that.
But I can get it working the next time. I know what I did wrong.
Yeah, everywhere, man. Ah.
Sorry. I know how to do it. I promise you, I can get it working this time.
Yeah, you better, pal. Take two, let's do this. Okay.
Are you
all right? Yeah, fine, let's go again. Let's go again, come on. Okay, so here we are, the final take. This is where, this is basically where I die.
Yeah, and hopefully Matt will activate the safety system this time around.
So it's on green, so it's working.
Do we really have to do this? All right, I'm putting the kit bag just a little bit in front of me. And I'm stepping back just very slightly. I'm alive! Woohoo!
We're going to really test out how this car drives now. We've got the 190 horsepower D4 diesel engine. Strangely and amazingly, it delivers a 99 grams per kilometre, which is fantastic. Average miles per gallon of around 50. Okay, so one of the incredible things about this car are the safety features that it comes with. It steers to keep you in the right lane. So it's got this steering system where if I actually take my hand off the steering wheel now, the steering wheel will actually start to turn, and it's freaky because it won't let me go over the lines, although it will get close. Now listen, it doesn't drive for you. It is a safety feature and therefore not to be used in replacement of a human being. It'll keep you in the lane. It knows the distance that you are from the right lane and the left lane and using the lines. And it's clever. I mean, it's very clever. I've had a lot of fun with this.
Matt.
Yeah.
Volvo.
Yep, this Volvo is awesome. One of the really cool things about this is it's got one of the nicest sort of radar guided cruise control systems I've ever used. So if I set it at, let's say, 80 miles an hour, nope, I'm gonna change that to 70 miles an hour.
Of course, yeah.
All my feet and everything are off the braking systems, off the throttle. If I come in behind this truck here, right, automatically it's slowing us right down, absolutely slowing us down. So it's giving us a safe stopping distance between the vehicle there and there. I like this car. I don't know if I like it £36,000 much. £35,000 much, but I'm liking what I'm seeing so far.
So Matt, what did you think?
What a great car.
Wicked.
Let's go check it out.
You know, the lines it's got, it actually looks more like an estate car, but it's a hybrid between the two, isn't it? It's like an estate stroke hatchback. It definitely looks faster than it drives, doesn't it?
Oh, absolutely. Well, you've got the twin pipes, got the cool diffuser down the bottom here, in the boot.
Good size boot.
Yeah, really good.
A lot of people are going to love this because it's a decent sized boot, but it's split level. So you can pull that up and put other bits and pieces underneath.
Yeah, not the normal crap that we've got in there though. Actually, this is fairly tidy for us. Enough space for the kids. Space in the back, there's loads of space. Look at this. I mean, Matt, you're really small, but...
You're only about 2.5 foot tall.
Considerably taller than you though, Matt. Anyway, so look, I think we're all in agreement. This is a very nice looking car.
The car looks awesome.
Yep.
It drives amazingly.
Yep.
And it's really well screwed together. All of the materials they've chosen.
Build quality is fantastic.
Fantastic. Right, so it's your go to drive it.
I'm going to drive it this time.
Feel safe.
Anybody who steps in a Volvo feels safe. It's like a standard thing.
You do get that feeling actually, don't you? Like everything's solid. Not only solid to drive, but like it would be solid in a crash as well.
You know, the dashboard is squidgy.
Feels like the inside of your pants, Matt. Squidgy.
Guys, how would you know what the inside of my pants is like, you weirdo?
I wouldn't know
You're
that.
Such a weird person.
I wouldn't know that. Only you know that.
What are you thinking so far?
It's hugely...
cheap on road tax? Go left.
Zero road tax.
Go left. Go left, go straight ahead.
Why?
Because that's what I'm telling you to do. Actually, no, you need to go in behind this douchebag here.
What, in the bus lane? Matt, you're going to get us in trouble.
Jared, we're misting up and...
Yeah, I'm trying to sort it out.
What are you doing? I can't even see. It's like suddenly you've... Oh, wow, look, it's magically clearing.
It isn't, it's getting worse.
Oh, hang on a second.
And also, the steering wheel should have been a flat bottom.
Yeah,
should have been a flat bottom steering wheel. Matthew, stop it, please. Matthew, stop it. Matthew, stop it. Matthew, please. Jesus Christ, stop it. Sorry, Matthew, this is not even funny. Right, now I've stalled the car. Pub. Okay, so we're at the pub. Look, to summarise, are we all big fans of the Volvo?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, we always say on every single vehicle that we love it. You know, because of individual qualities.
We find things that we like about the car, so was there anything that we disliked? Quickly.
The only thing is rear visibility, because the headrests and the rear sit quite high.
Yeah, and if I'm being honest, I didn't like the light front end. To me, it oversteered just a little bit.
Yeah.
Understeered just a little bit.
But I've got to stress, that wouldn't put me off buying one.
I think
every car's got a positive and a negative.
Yeah.
You know, and that's
definitely more positives than negatives. Ratings out of 5?
Out of 5, I would go with a 4.5, only because of the rear visibility. That's it.
Yeah, I'm going to go 4.5.
Chris, I understand you've got some questions for us.
Yeah, you're going to test our general knowledge on Volvos.
Wait, just before we start.
Hang on.
Is there any way Matt could have possibly cheated?
I swear to you, I have not cheated.
Okay. The machinery Volvo used to crash test cars was originally designed for what?
Okay, so there we have it. Apparently we know a lot about Volvo. I think we're all in complete agreement. 4.5 stars unanimously amongst us brothers.
Mm-hmm.
I'd just like to say it's been a pleasure filming this week's episode. We've all thoroughly enjoyed it.
Fantastic
we hope you
time.
Have too.
Yep.
So please subscribe on YouTube, poke us or like us on Facebook and tweet us on Twitter. And guys, I think that's about the end of the show.
Well, there is one more thing.
Get out of here. Come on, let's move.
Okay. Right,
let's go. Let's do it.
The Japanese are busy people, and it's no wonder when Japan is the fourth richest country in the world. Renowned for its technological exports, electronics, and sushi, Japan's largest export is motor cars, and it's worth over $142 billion annually. Just a tickle over that of Justin Bieber. So naturally, cars for these guys are big business. And they know how to make them. And what's more, they know how to make them better than the rest of us.
Hello and welcome to Talk Show. In today's episode, we've got the remarkable Mazda MX-5 Mark I. Originally debuted at the Chicago Motor Show in 1989, this little puppy was a smash hit. Okay, we're going to hit the streets in all three cars. We're going to have a great deal of fun. There's going to be a little bit of drifting. We're going to horribly embarrass Jared.
Thanks a lot.
We love that. And the Wheel of Doom.
Okay, on that rather uncomfortable note, stay tuned in.
The Mazda MX-5 is the best-selling two-seat sports convertible in car history. And that's something to be proud of. And now, there have been four generations of this remarkable little car, the latest of which is to be launched in the UK any minute now. But we're not here to talk about that one. We are here to talk about this one.
I want you to see what 900 pounds of MX-5 looks like.
I'm seeing scratches down the side.
Yes.
I'm seeing dents everywhere.
Yes.
Bird shit.
Bask in its glory, fellas, I'm telling you.
What are these wheels?
They are very sought after wheels. They're wasabis.
Watanabe.
Watanabes.
Yeah. Right, why is your car leaking water?
It sheds weight. And like me, it needs to urinate every so often.
So it leaks like a sieve?
Leaks.
And that's what 900 quid of Mazda MX-5 gets you?
Listen, it's MOT'd. It's taxed. This thing is amazing. Check it out. Look.
You have one seat.
Yeah, one seat. That was a factory optional extra. I've got the number 40 on the back.
Which represents the amount of dents and scratches on your car?
Actually, it's closer to the number of owners. But look, it's got a roll cage.
So how many owners does this actually have, this one?
About 11.
Okay, plus obviously the amount of, you know, before it was imported, amount of... Let's move on to George's car.
Okay, so £2,000. George, tell us a little bit about it.
What would you like to know?
Well, it's £2,000, right? What does it look and drive like?
It's blue, and it drives like a car.
Okay, and anything else you can tell us?
Nope.
George, has yours got like electric windows? Because yours is an import as well.
It has everything. Seats, wheels, handbrake.
Nice. Yeah, pretty decent.
Mirror, it also has one of these.
This is nice.
This is pretty amazing. And I love the colour as well, man.
That's the nice thing about it. It looks really tidy for one of these.
Well, George, thank you very much for elaborating on your car. So decisive and so, you know, thoroughly.
You're
very
welcome.
Good of you. Right, Matt, this little thing, right, is immaculate condition, I have to say.
It is.
Is that Ferrari red, though?
No, that's not what it's about. This is £5,000.
This is right at the top.
It is.
For a Mark 1,
yeah,
I suppose.
The paintwork is amazing. Mm. The interior is immaculate. This is a two-owner Mazda MX-5 from new. You know, the wheels are mint. It drives beautifully. Now, it's not as racy as yours because it doesn't have the strut brake.
No, it hasn't been modded up.
No. However, under the bonnet, it does have a strut brake and it looks pretty impressive.
Can you just focus in on how immaculate this car is, please? That's it's grease.
Are you ready? How immaculate is that? It's also all about the detail.
Yeah, he's gone to town on the detail, hasn't he?
Absolutely. Yeah,
all right.
This car is just...
That is really
lovely.
Nice.
It's
really
done
nice.
A genuine 90,000 miles with a full service history. Gosh. Now, this is also one of the very last of the Mark 1s. This is a 1997 registered vehicle.
And also, as well, the two Unoses, they came with power steering as well as electric windows.
This hasn't gone in yet, that.
So, for £5,000, you're actually getting a little bit less, but you're getting a UK car,
yes,
less owners,
great,
and a higher grade. £100, and it really puts a smile on my face.
It handles superbly, and what a treat for very little money.
So the guys today have roped me into driving one of these MX-5s. What you'll notice about the Unos Roadster that I'm driving now is that it stops at every single goddamn traffic light.
And it's not quick, not by any standard whatsoever.
Incredible. Such a good little car.
Awesome.
bit hairdressery, let's just say. And the 0 to 60s weren't particularly quick, therefore it was a car that I was never going to be very interested in.
But that being said, it's because I never drove one.
So, with George having finally caught up, we ditched the production crew, found ourselves a remote location, and had a play whilst waiting for the rest of the team to arrive.
So here I am with Matt. We're at the Handbrake drifty, skiddy location. Some have not survived, as you can clearly see here.
Jared's clearly been driving this car.
Yeah, Matt just knocked into that about 5 minutes ago. Nice. Here's we've got George. Wave, George. Nice. That's how he rolls. Man, this is cray cray.
Cray cray, what the f- is cray cray?
Have you never heard of cray cray?
No, I have not heard of cray cray. You've clearly just made
that up. Come around that side. So this is my new present. I got a selfie stick. Mine's a cheap selfie stick.
So what was yours? $7.99.
I don't know. It came from Poland.
A selfie stick.
A self ski stick.
A self ski stick. A self ski.
Priceless.
A self stick.
Okay, so basically this is the Wheel of Doom, and the way it works is, Jerry, by the way, you're going to be going first on this task. If it lands on one of the black ones, okay, that's an instant pass and it moves on from you to myself or to George, okay?
Yeah.
If it lands on one of the orange ones, that's the terrifying stunt that you have to carry out.
Okay, and am I right in saying that when you don't want to accept the stunt, you then have to face a forfeit?
Yes.
Is that right?
The other brothers.
The other brothers have got to do. So we can decide if you're too rubbish to do the stunt, we can decide something horrible to happen to you in the forfeit, yeah?
For you, yes.
Okay.
Let's spin that wheel. Yes, a cliff dive.
Okay, whoa, guys, hang on. What exactly is the cliff dive?
Chris, tell us about the cliff dive.
You have to drive a car off a cliff.
That was obvious.
Hang on, guys.
Don't worry about it. You can do the forfeit if you don't want to do this.
I'm not comfortable with this. I'm scared of heights. You ran me over with the Volvo.
We
okay,
did.
I took that.
Ah! Jesus Christ.
Yeah, man.
This is...
jumping off a cliff, guys.
A, I'm scared of heights.
B, I don't want to drive a car off a cliff. So all the other ones sound like they're fairly...
Jerry.
I'd rather do the flaming ring. Can I do the flaming ring?
No. You can do...
Can we spin it again?
The forfeit, though. And George and I will work out something.
Oh, you guys, I'm not having a forfeit set by you two.
Forfeit?
No way. Yeah, of course I'm nervous. This is humiliating.
You should have done the stunt, mate. George,
I was not doing the stunt.
No.
No goddamn way. Okay, what about that guy? No. Definitely not that guy. All right, are we going with this guy or not?
All right, just go.
Yeah, go
do this guy?
Go on.
All right, let's go. Hello. Hi. How you doing? You all right? I'm Gerard. I'm from Talk Show. Have you got a couple of minutes just to chat about your car?
Tell me a little bit about it. How long have you had it?
About a month.
About a month?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ask him if he can stroke it. Stroke his car.
So, I love the colour. It's,
we want you to look at the passenger seat.
Can I just move your seat back here a little bit?
Get closer and sniff it.
Sniff it.
That's strange. How it smells?
Smells...
Ask him, has this car ever been involved in dogging?
Have you, do you know if there's any previous history of dogging in the car?
Not really, but that sits, it's my missus sits, and
That's your missus, yeah. I'm really sorry.
Ask him if he can kiss his car goodbye.
Oh, do you mind if I just kiss it goodbye, quickly? Alright, thanks a lot. That was the most embarrassing thing I've ever done in the whole of my life.
You did well for that, actually. Oh, I'm really impressed. I bet you wish you drove off that cliff now.
Yeah, I really do. Okay, let me get me unplugged. I'm uncomfortable.
Yours at £5,000 though is
a lot of money.
It's a lot of money.
Yeah, but guys,
when you compare it to mine, 900 pundos.
Look, that's the whole idea of this particular show, wasn't it? To illustrate that you can go and buy a Mazda MX-5 for £900, £2,000, or you can have the creme de la creme for £5,000.
The Mark One, anyway.
You can still have as much fun, you know. And yours is all beaten up and rubbish.
Sorry, what was that, Chris? You've got some questions for us.
Yeah, I've got a quiz.
What do you got for us?
Okay. Question number one. The Mazda MX-5 is the best what in history?
Is it the best-selling two-seater car in the world?
Yes.
Hang on. Yes. Hang on. Whoa. Well, keep going, Chris. Number two.
What does MX-5 stand for?
Mazda.
Yeah.
Just thought it was like a... I don't know.
I think we should put it out there. We've done no research.
Is it X? Like
it stands for Mazda Experiment Project Number 5.
Now I did know that. I was just highlighting the fact that you guys didn't know.
Okay.
Do you actually know what the top speed of the MX-5 is?
127.
Well, I did 150.
Because I'm cool. I did my research. Thank you. Yeah.
My one is actually
that is really
that's
bad.
So unprofessional. So you know what? My Mazda.
Okay, so because Matthew failed so miserably at trying to keep up with George and I in the Mazda MX-5 quiz, I've actually used Google Translate to give Matthew the opportunity to redeem himself. He's going to have to learn some Japanese. So Matthew, if you want to just read out what we got here on the screen in your best possible Japanese, let's see what you got.
Watashi wa Matsuki uta homresu no ini no iki o moto imusu.
Okay, so to now see just exactly how close Matthew's Japanese skills are, we're going to listen to it properly. So
I
here
think
we go.
Pretty good.
Watashi wa homresu no inu no iki o motte imasu.
Okay, so good, not actually there. Bad. Okay, so we'll let you guys.
You can
decide.
Have a whole half a mark for that.
I've won now. That was like 50 points.
You're the winner.
I am the winner.
Okay, so there we go. I think you find that George and I clearly cleaned up in the pub quiz and know considerably more about the Mazda MX-5 than young Matthew. But
I did learn Japanese.
Yes, you did learn Japanese. Absolutely true. But also, I think you find that probably I was the best at drifting too, wouldn't you say, guys?
No, not at all.
How about we let George decide? George, who was the drifting?
Right, listen, jokes aside, this is a remarkable car. We've been banging on about it throughout the whole show. For under £5,000, you can really go and get a cracking car. It's absolutely brilliant. Don't you guys agree?
Absolutely, 1,000,000%. Brilliant little machine. Well, listen, thank you very much for tuning in. We hope you have enjoyed today's episode. Well, certainly as much as we've enjoyed making it, wouldn't you agree, guys?
Absolutely.
Brilliant. So look, follow us on Twitter, find us on Facebook, and visit our website, www.talkshow.tv. And guys, get ready for the next episode. We've got some seriously cool, exciting stuff coming up. But there we have it. We're out of here. Sayonara.
Two years ago, my brothers and I came up with the idea to make a show about cars that we would enjoy making as much as people could enjoy watching. We love cars, and we've owned literally hundreds of them. And spurred on by all the incredible things that you guys had to say about us in our first couple of shows, we are Talk Show.
Here we go.
What a
Welcome to Talk Show. This is our second episode.
Today we've got something a little bit special for you. We've pulled a few strings. Citroen have come together and given us the new Citroen C4 Cactus. Love it or hate it, it's a Marmite car. Matt, what do you think?
I kind of wanted to dislike the car immensely when I saw pictures of it, but it's growing on me.
Yeah, I drove it down here and I have to say, super impressed. Really, really, really like it.
So which one did you drive?
I drove the 1.2, 82 horsepower petrol.
Okay.
But it also comes in 100 horsepower diesel.
But that's a three-cylinder engine, yeah?
Three-cylinder.
Okay, well, this one, the one which I'm going to drive later on, is the 1.6 diesel, 100 horsepower blue.
I'm really excited to find out more and drive the car a lot more.
Sure,
and really get
me
to
too.
Explore.
Well, I think later on, we should stop and maybe ask the public what they think of the visual looks of the car, get a bit of feedback. But it is very much a Marmite car.
Definitely.
You're either going to love it or you're going to hate it.
Definitely a Marmite car. What do you think?
It looks great!
But anyway, have a look around the cars. Tell us what you think.
I quite liked it when I first saw it over there.
Yeah? What do you think, young man? Do you like that car? That's all right.
Is it comfortable in there?
I'm filming you. Filming me.
I'm filming you.
I'm filming you. Filming me. You like it? Yeah? Take that out so you won't drive off accidentally.
This is, aren't they? Yes. And then people open their doors,
that's right,
and you know, or you get the trolley dinks.
I think they're going to be starting at 12.995.
Really?
Yeah.
It's an excellent car. Very, very.
Glad you like it. George, what do you think?
It's good.
So listen, let's go take these cars for a drive. Let's put them side by side. Let's see what they drive like and learn a little bit more about the cars inside as well. Let's do it. This really is a defining car for Citroen. The C4 Cactus is the first of their new split between the DS range and the new economical, quirky designed Citroen range. And so the Cactus really brings us everything that the new C line is to encompass. It's economical, it's efficient, it's lightweight, it's simple.
What were you saying?
Citroen is all about just quirk and economy. This represents Citroen and Citroen's future.
Okay.
That's what Carlos Tavera, the new global managing director of Citroen Peugeot, says.
Nine. Mission operation. Launch approval. Launch approval. Launch approval.
One of the things we keep going on about are these air bumps. These. Very different to any other car. You can squidge them in, so if somebody opens their door, bang, it's not going to do any damage. Air bump. That's all I need to say. There's all sorts of quirky things you can have and you can spec up. These can go to white, you can choose different coloured cactus strips that go in here. Boot space, now we've got loads of crap in the boots. It's a generous size. Now, one issue I noticed is these are not split folding rear seats. It goes down as one. I don't know why they did that. Back windows, there is no mechanism for the windows to go down, but they do pop out. When you're driving down the road and you've got them open, you're not going to get that noise you do if you have the... Okay, inside I noticed there's only one cup holder, but at least they put a cup holder in, but there is only one.
It's good of the French to at least remember this time.
You've got these seats and they're really comfortable.
Super comfy, right?
Yeah.
They're super soft, but they hold you well. They've gone old school. It's kind of like that in the whole dash here area, isn't it? These dashboards are just a litter of buttons and stuff. They've taken out all that clutter and they put it all in this touchscreen system here, leaving the
dash really clean. And
oh, look, they're all like staring.
So many people are looking.
Which that sounds... guy's vomiting. Why is that guy vomiting?
Okay, so how does it drive, Matt? That's the important question.
Right, well, it drives really well. Because you've been driving that 1.2 one today.
I drove the 1.2. I liked it. Okay, it's a little bit underpowered, but then when you're talking about 70 mpg, I can live with that. All of the cars are under a ton, meaning that they're just like super efficient. And so, again, I know you've said it before, but zero road tax.
Yeah, no, that's incredible.
There's three different specifications, which is the touch, yep, feel, yep, and the flare.
Okay. Go for the flare, you're going to get the sat nav, you're going to get the hard drive, a hi-fi pack, you're going to get these nicer wheels, you're going to get the park assist. We are going to go to the parking button, enter parking slot, I'm going to indicate, and it's going to scan a space. Okay, so sit the car in reverse, hands off steering wheel, and off we go. I'm just doing the throttle, and I am doing the brakes, which is pretty neat. Nice and tidily, there you go, sorts the steering out for us there. Yep, okay, cool, fantastic.
What are those black bits then?
These are like rubber things.
Oh. We're gonna pop that on the dash. Okay, ready?
Yeah.
No way.
That is awesome, that doesn't actually
move. That's cool. That is super cool. Yeah. I can't believe that.
None of the cars have got rev counters either. What you do get is you get this coming
gear
up to the right.
Gear efficiency indicator.
Yeah. They want you to change at the most economical point. Yeah. So the steering is really light as well, and it's got a good steering lock.
Okay, let's get out.
It's not the fastest thing in the world, but you know, it feels comfortable and it was great to drive.
I think all three of us wanted to dislike the car.
As I said,
From its initial look, this is the thing. It's we said from the beginning.
Within minutes, I was actually starting to like it.
Yeah, but you certainly get to love it once you get in it, you drive it, and you appreciate what it is. It's like anything when it's new, people just want to dislike it. There was a Facebook page that I came across the other day, and they were saying some horrific things.
Haters.
Don't look at it. Yeah, real age, literally.
Yeah.
Style meeting practicality and affordability, isn't it?
That front end is wicked as well. Those LEDs that are blended into the body.
When it's following you, when you were following us, it looked really quite aggressive from the front.
Yeah,
it does.
Kind of
cool.
Yeah, it doesn't look as good from the back, in my opinion. But you sort of forget about
that. It's a bit lame.
Yeah, look, they compromise a little bit.
Scores out of 5.
4.5. I think it's great value.
Okay.
Well, you'll get it.
Right, I'm going to say 4 out of 5.
Okay.
It's like a concept car that's actually being put into production.
It is.
Jerry, what do you think?
Yeah. I'm going to give it a 5. Good style. Really well thought of and considered. Like, really, really well thought out. But for what and who it's aimed at, it is. It just does everything. And I really, really, really admire that. Thank you all very much, ladies and gentlemen, for taking the time to watch our second episode of Talk Show. We hope you enjoyed it. We hope you enjoyed learning a little bit more about the Citroen C4 Cactus. I know we all did. Tune in for our next episode. Please subscribe on YouTube and like us on Facebook and tweet us on Twitter. I need to finish my pint. So, right,
you do what you need to do.